Welcome to SportsCenter. I'm Stephen A. Smith. The Nets are preparing to take on the Knicks tonight, but the big news is that they made a blockbuster deal to acquire one of the NBA's most prolific scorers, the Beard himself, James Harden. Here are the notable details on a 4-team trade. Harden is heading to the Nets, while the Rockets get 4 first-round picks, 4 pick swaps from Brooklyn, and Victor Oladipo. They got Oladipo from the Pacers, while Caris LeVert is heading to Indiana. The Cavaliers acquired Jared Allen and Torian Prince to complete the deal. Time to welcome in the man, the ultimate NBA insider who broke this story with our own Ramona Shelburne, the one and only Adrian Wojnarowski. Woj, how did this trade happen so quickly? Break this down for us.
Stephen, over the last few days, these talks started to gain some momentum, and ultimately, Brooklyn and Philadelphia were the two teams who were willing to kind of go the distance and putting packages together to try to get a player of James Harden's caliber. Those talks went through last night into this morning. And then this afternoon, really once Houston found a fourth team in the deal, Indiana, to move Caris LeVert for Victor Oladipo, there was a trade in place. And this is what Brooklyn wanted to do all along, find a third star for Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving. They did it. They did it at a steep price, but they've landed James Harden.
Woj, how long had this been percolating? We've been hearing about this for quite some time, that James Harden obviously wanted to end up in Brooklyn, but then we were here in Philadelphia, and then you take into consideration Kyrie Irving and what's been going on.
Superstar co-star for Kevin Durant, regardless of what Kyrie's future is with the Nets.
Woj, thanks, but I got bad news for you. After all the work you put in, you can't go anywhere. I need you again. I'll be back to you shortly. Don't go anywhere. Lots of stuff, dude, to still get into. Listen, it was a mix of good and bad for James Harden in Houston. He won several awards, including the 2018 MVP and 3 consecutive scoring titles. First player to do that since Kevin Durant almost a decade ago. But the Rockets did not have much success in the playoffs despite making the postseason in every season. They only reached the conference finals twice, falling short of the finals both times. Possibly the highlight of Harden's time in Houston, though, came during the 2017-18 season when he recorded at least 30 points in 32 straight games. That is the second longest streak of all time behind the one and only Wilt Chamberlain. However, in his last 4 games, they were the lowest in his time in Houston. Harden failed to score more than 20 points in 4 consecutive games, his longest streak as a member of the Houston Rockets. We now welcome in the wonderful Doris Burke, who will call the Nets and Knicks game tonight on ESPN. Reaction to the trade, Doris, what are your thoughts?
I had 2 very quick thoughts in succession. The first one was a championship-level team with Kyrie Irving and Kevin Durant enhance their championship possibilities. You don't add one of the great scorers ever in the history of the league. You just went through all the accomplishments of James Harden and not raise your window as a championship organization. It's just too dangerous on the offensive end. My second one, Stephen, was this isn't without its challenges. Number one, on the defensive end, you've got some issues. You trade away your rim protector, a guy who did a tremendous job at the rim for you, and Jared Allen. But also, Kevin Durant has proven he can play alongside another MVP in Steph Curry, an elite two-way player in Klay Thompson, and still rise to the top of that group, 2-time finals MVP. What we don't know, Kyrie Irving bristled alongside LeBron James when he played with him. James Harden's a guy who has had trouble getting along with Chris Paul, now Russell Westbrook. It didn't work. Those two guys need the ball. So how this all meshes in a compressed schedule with very little practice time remains to be seen. Is it doable? Yes, because all three are great players, but it's not without its challenges.
Doris, in Boston in 2008, you had Ray Allen as a third option. That was an adjustment, but he handled it. They won a title. Chris Bosh was a third option in Miami. They won 2 titles in 4 years. Of course, you had Klay Thompson in Golden State. They won 3 titles in 5 years. Who's going to be the third option in this trifecta? And more importantly, who'll be receptive to it, if anybody at all?
Well, that's a great question. And obviously, you know, Kevin Durant, think about what he does the other night. You're down 18. There's turmoil surrounding your entire roster. You needed a win desperately. I mean, Steve Nash said it was good for our soul. That's how the feeling was around this group with all the Kyrie uncertainty. So, you know, You want him to shine. And again, I go back to the point, Kyrie Irving and James Harden have proven at their best they need the basketball in their hands. And even watching the brief repetitions with Kyrie and Kevin Durant, it's like one has the ball for a stretch of time and then the other has the ball for the stretch of time. The honest answer to that question is, I don't know. And it's why a collection of talent doesn't always translate to championships. How this meshes, what Steve Nash has in front of him is a unique and interesting challenge.
Always love talking to you, Doris. Thank you so much, and have a good time calling that game tonight between the Nets and the Knicks and the Nets. Thank you so much. Oh, I've been waiting to talk to this next guest right here. Our NBA analyst, champion with the Boston Celtics, one and only Kendrick Perkins. Your reaction to this deal, do you feel it's a good thing for the Brooklyn Nets?
Stephen A., surprisingly, I don't. And here's why. Yes, you have all the offensive power in the world, but guess what? Defense wins championships. And you can't tell me a last NBA championship team in the last 5 years that wasn't top five defensively. And I'm looking at this roster and I'm saying, who in the hell is going to guard? Who's going to guard Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown? Who's going to guard Joel Embiid? You need people out there that's going to defend at a high level. And when I'm looking at this Brooklyn Nets team and what they did, I strongly believe that they dropped the ball by getting rid of Jared Allen. He was their rim protector. He was their lob threat. He anchored the defense. So right now, one word comes to mind, Stephen A., on the offensive end, sacrifice. Who is going to sacrifice? Everyone can't have the basketball. It's only one of them.
I'll be back to you in a few, Kendrick Perkins. Don't you go anywhere. I need to get back to Woj for a second here because another part of this blockbuster deal needs to be discussed. That's Victor Oladipo going to Houston and Caris LeVert going to Indiana. What's the thought behind this part of the deal, Woj?
Well, I think for Indiana, it was a chance to get a very good young player in Caris LeVert, who's on a good contract, you know, who I think really fits in there with Malcolm Brogdon and Domantas Sabonis, Miles Turner. That's a good playoff team. And in Indiana, clearly there was not a future. That partnership had really been frayed between Victor Oladipo and the Pacers. And, you know, they were ready to move on from each other. And now Houston has a chance to either take a look at Victor. Do they want to re-sign him? He'll be a free agent in the offseason. They could move him again, though, before the trade deadline. So they have some options in Houston with Oladipo.
Woj, appreciate the great work as always, buddy. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Steve.
The Rockets are going to look a little different now with James Harden in Brooklyn. John Wall is still a point guard and will have Victor Oladipo right by his side. Christian Wood will lead the front court. And DeMarcus Cousins.
Look, Brooklyn Nets in just a couple of minutes. 7:30 Eastern here on ESPN. DeAndre Jordan in his 13th season in the NBA. Going to have to get adjusted to one new teammate and James Harden. Oh, this is going to be fun to watch. NBA front office insider Bobby Marks joins us now live to talk about the money part of it, because you're our expert with contracts and salaries. So when you look at the Nets, Bobby, James Harden at $41 million a year, Kevin Durant $39 million, Kyrie at about $33 million. It's a lot of money. How did Brooklyn make this work?
Yeah, Sage, let's do some fun math right now. And when you look at that Harden number, which is that 41.2 million dollars, the Nets had to get within 125% of that number, which means about $33 million in salary to go out. So when you start adding it up with the Caris LeVert contract and the Torian Prince and the Jared Allen, you were just a little bit short. Now you add Rodion Skurics to that deal and it works by about $1.5 million. So $8 million difference, the Nets add about $15 million in additional luxury tax, but you get within that 125% number.
And now you're the favorite to come out of the Eastern Conference. And now it is, according to many people, finals or bust for the Brooklyn Nets. What about Indiana and Cleveland? We're not hearing many people talk about those two teams right now. As the Pacers get rid of Victor Oladipo, disgruntled and a big salary and an expiring contract, get Caris LeVert, as you mentioned. Cleveland, a big man in Jared Allen. The financial aspect of it for these two teams is what?
Well, for Indiana, it protects them with Victor Oladipo, who is going to be a free agent in 2021 and, you know, this offseason, where he could have commanded a salary in that $30 million range. You get Caris LeVert back, who's earning $16 million. under contract for two more years past this season. And the same for Cleveland. They've got Andre Drummond, who is going to be a free agent. Jared Allen's a restricted free agent, will probably cost you half of that amount. So it protects both teams, you know, for the future here.
That's a lot of money. At the end of the day, it seems like everybody got better. Thank goodness we have Bobby Marks to break that down for us. Bobby, thank you so much for the latest on this really historic day in the NBA. A lot of money, Kevin, a lot of...